I think that right now, everybody's all about the iPads and the iPhones and mobile technologies. And I think that we need to really identify carefully what applications we're providing individuals. I think that currently there's too much out there, and it's very difficult to navigate that process. And we are purchasing very expensive apps for certain individuals without truly evaluating if that's a good match for that individual. Using this rubric or an adapted version of the rubric, it will help us identify much better what apps are truly going to be more beneficial and what truly is the app that's going to meet that purpose for that individual. So we can go back to individualization and the differentiation between what each person actually needs. We went back to the literature to try to identify if there was already something out there that individuals with intellectual disabilities could actually use to evaluate apps. And what we found is that people were talking about these app evaluation, but nobody had officially evaluated them to see if they were good or not. We started off the project by creating a rubric to use for individuals with intellectual disabilities. At that point, the ARC hired a group of eight raters, and they integrated these raters, and we provided training to two of the ARC team members, and they were the ones who were actually going to train the individuals with disabilities. We served as the liaison to make sure that everything was happening to support. We created all the training materials for them. We created the adapted rubric. We created PowerPoints, task analysis, and we tested the apps, all of us, on our own first before we even had individuals with intellectual disabilities evaluate these. That way we could actually compare the results. So most of the apps that we worked with at this time were all basically video modeling or task analysis apps that would break concepts or tasks that the individual has to do on daily living, break it up for them to be able to complete the task independently. The rating scale that we created for them was divided in four main sections. It was content, individualization, usability, and quality. So in the content, was the content appropriate in for what you wanted to use the app? In the individualization was the components of, like, can you change things to meet your specific needs? So for example, if an individual had a visual impairment, can they make the text larger? Can they make the text smaller? Is there auditory output? The usability is how easy it was to navigate and how easy it was used, be able to use it independently and fast enough that it didn't have to take forever for you to figure out the app before you can actually use it. And the quality is basically, that was more your opinion. Overall, did you like it or not like it? So I think that the Pictello overall had all around better scores. People like the usability and the fact of the content seemed to be very easy to navigate and identify components that they were interested in. I think that the other apps that we evaluated, most of all of them needed a lot more task into putting it all together. We have written a very small draft to publicize on the State Department's website, just to kind of provide general information of what happened, what we do, and what were the results. But at the same time, we are writing a research paper to publish both the preliminary rubric and also the adapted version of the rubric. And we are writing those papers currently to make sure that they get published so all the public knows about the rubric that we created and how the results actually may have an impact on future evaluations of apps. This collaboration would have been possible without the enabling technology program of the Tennessee State Department. it was beneficial for everybody involved because individuals with disabilities were hired to complete a task that is going to be beneficial for them and it's going to help them in their future skills. The ARC benefited in regards that two of their employees were directly working with all these individuals and got trained and were very supportive. And then our students actually got benefited from this because they did work hard on this project, were able to work with all these different associations, were able to collaborate, network, and so many more things that really occurred on this that, you know, I don't think this would have been possible without their support and the opportunity to have some financial support because we did have to buy the apps and all that stuff. So I think that we hope that the collaboration continues.